all, how you doing? Surf and Sopple here, SS. Welcome back to another episode of Cooking with Surf and Sopple. Glad you're here, folks. Know how today we're going to make meatballs and lemon and egg sauce. It's a Greek recipe. It's very easy to make. I mean, there's hardly anything to it. Let me just go ahead and get started and show you what we got. First of all, you got to have meat to make meatballs. So I got 2 pounds of sirloin that's been ground up. Then you're going to have 1 cup of rice, 1 onion diced, and salt and pepper and garlic, which is made by Suckle Busters. I've talked about this a number of times, you know. Everyone should already be familiar. Woo! That stuff is a trip. I got eggs right here, and then I still have to go out back and get the lemons. All right, so let's just get started. Very simple. Get your mixing bowl. Oh, and you need butter. Start grabbing stuff and put it in. Don't worry about it. We're going to mix this all up. Get all the onions. Put them in. Put your rice in. Get some Suckle Busters or any salt, pepper, garlic mix. That's about 2 tablespoons. And just start kneading it like it's dough, okay? Man, that stuff's a trip. Golly. If you ever see me cough in these videos, it's because that stuff's high quality. Powerful. Anyway, I'm just going to keep doing this until it's all mixed up. It shouldn't take that long, but just keep doing it. You're going to have rice all mixed. It ain't got to be perfect, folks. You know what I mean? You're just mixing it up. Every meatball is going to be a little bit different, so. Okay. Then whatever size you like. If you like tennis ball size, that's fine. We better go with about golf ball size. Just kind of make a ball. About like that, see? The golf ball. Big golf ball. So let me do the rest of these, and we'll proceed. Okay, I've got all these meatballs prepared now. And what I got over here is a half a pot of water with that whole stick of butter in there. And I got it on a low simmer. So what we're going to do is just take these balls one at a time and drop them in. I don't know if you can see this, but you can kind of get the feel for it, I hope. Now, I don't know if this pot's big enough, but hopefully it is. If it isn't, then we'll just wish that it was. And move forward, folks. There's no rules. Cooking's not like war. There's no rules. Yeah, we might end up with a couple extras. Come on, get down in there, boy. Yeah, doggone it. Oh, well. I'll figure that out. But you get the point. You're kind of boiling the meatballs, okay? Anyway, I'll deal with those in a little bit. We'll worry about them later. Actually, this guy needs to go down further. Or get out. Take that one out, put him under. All right, now they're all under. Covered with water and butter. Okay, over here we have the juice of about 4 or 5 of my Mexican limes. And then we have some cackle fruits right here. And I'm gonna just knock the cackle fruits in this bowl, crack them and dump them in. Don't worry about it, folks. They're just cackle fruit, as JB would call them. Just whip it up. Some people like to take the yolk out of the white and all that, but I don't really care. Get it light, nice and frothy. Now pour your lemon juice in. Do the same thing. Okay, now what we have here is lemon juice and egg. We sit this to the side until these are ready, then I'll show you what we're gonna do. All right, this has been boiling for around 20 minutes. Simmer boil, let's take the lid off. Okay, this egg and lemon been all whisked up. I was gonna try something different. It doesn't call for this, but this crema mexicana, I'm going to put a little bit of that in with this, kind of cream it out a little bit. I think that might be something to think about. So let me whisk that in. Then I'm going to show you, it's not a secret, but it's a necessity. Don't ever just pour this in there because this is kind of at a different temp. You're going to need to get some of the juice out of here that's hot, the hot boiling juice. Ladle a couple spoonfuls of this into here, so that this becomes warm. Because if you put cold with hot, it's gonna curdle, it's gonna turn into cottage eggs. So you wanna get it close to that temperature, but over here. You see? It's still not hot enough, so it'll take a little more. Part of cooking. I don't know what it's called. There's a name for it. It's called not screwing up. It's getting warmer. I'm gonna go about two more and then that should do it. One, two. These smell really well, good. Okay, now we can just pour this in this while it's already boiling and let it get in there and get everybody get to know each other. Let me get this out of the way. Now just kind of move it around, let everybody get to know each other. And see, now that egg is going to froth up. Look at that, see it? It's frothy. This is coming out perfect. This is a Greek dish, folks. So now just leave it in here. Don't bring it to a crazy boil now. Just leave it in here for a little bit. Let it stay warm. Maybe a simmer. And then after that, I'm going to put it over here in this beautiful dish that I got. And make it look real nice. And then we'll test it out, okay? Okay, folks, we're done. I put all of it in there that would fit, and then I put the rest in here in this bowl. You eat it in a bowl. It's kind of like a soup, like a meatball, Greek meatball soup. So very, very lovely, very good flavor. Let's try it out. As you could tell, this is only half of a meatball. I've been trying it out, folks, before I started recording. I'm a bad boy. I had to, man. It's just drive me crazy. It smells so good. Anyway, get the piece of crush the meatball up and get some juice in there with it and then test it out. Man, that's good. That is good, folks. This is delicious, actually. I've never had it before. I've had it with chicken, but not with the beef meatballs. Man, very, 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 very killer. We might need to be a little bit more lemony, but if this is the way it's supposed to be, it's okay. It's good, man. So anyway, we got this whole thing left. Got this, and I'm fitting to eat, folks. So thanks for watching. Stop by next week again. Hopefully we'll have a review video coming to you in the middle of the week. And like I always say, please subscribe, leave a comment, and if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, tell all your friends, and share on all social medias, okay? I really appreciate you all, and I'm almost going to hit 6,000. Actually, by the time you see this, it might have already been 6,000. We'll have to celebrate together somehow. You know, I like to celebrate. I like to give stuff away. All right, folks. God bless you. We'll see you next time. Adios.